ஹலோ ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ், ஐ எம் கண்ணன், ப்ரொஃபஸர் மெக்கானிக்கல் இன்ஜினியரிங், அஞ்சலியம்மாள் மகாலயம் இன்ஜினியரிங் காலேஜ், கோவில்வண்ணி. ஐ எம் ஹாப்பி டு மீட் யூ அகெய்ன் த்ரூ திஸ் லெக்சர் நம்பர் 5 ஆன் மாடியூல் 1 இன் தி சப்ஜெக்ட் ஆப்ரேஷன்ஸ் ரிசர்ச். த டாபிக் டுடே இஸ் சிம்ப்ளக்ஸ் மெத்தட் ப்ராப்ளம்ஸ். ஸோ வி சால்வ் 3 ப்ராப்ளம்ஸ் இன் தி சிம்ப்ளக்ஸ் யூசிங் தி சிம்ப்ளக்ஸ் மெத்தட் ஸோ தட் the student you may understand the procedure to solve the problem using the simplex method. We recap from the previous lectures. We discussed the standard form of LPP, so converting given linear programming problem into a standard form by adding slack or the surplus variable on the constraint equations, and converting the entire problem and representing in the form of a table. And we know there is objective function in the LPP, which may be maximization or minimization type. And all the decision variables are non-negative. And we have some constraint in the equation, in the problem. The constraints are inequalities, but we have to convert into equations, algebraic equations with the non-negative right-hand side. And there are other 3 important terminology in the solution procedure: leaving variable or leaving row, entering variable or entering column, and the intersection of the entering variable and leaving variable is called as pivot number. So we'll see in detail. We take a problem, you solve the problem using the simplex method. Maximize z equal to 3x1 plus 4x2. Subject to x1 plus x2 less than or equal to 450, 2x1 plus x2 less than or equal to 600, and x1, x2, they are greater than or equal to 0. This is the simple problem with the 2 variables. This is a 2 variable problem. It can be very much solved by the graphical method, but to understand the simplex procedure, we take a simple problem, then later on we take 3 variable problem. And if you look at the constraint, we have to convert the inequality constraint into equal algebraic equations. In the both the constraints, we have to add slack variable. So x1 plus x2 less than or equal to 450, we have to convert this as x1 plus x2 plus s1 is equal to 450. And 2x1 plus x2 less than or equal to 600, this you have to convert it as 2x1 plus x2 plus s2. So here we have to add s2 equal to 600. So you convert and represent the problem in the standard form. So this is the standard form of the linear programming problem. By introducing the slack variable to the constraint equation, the standard LPP. So look at the constraint equation. Yes, x1 plus x2 plus s1 equal to 450, 2x1 plus x2 plus s2 is equal to 600, and all the 4 variables x1, x2, s1, s2 greater than or equal to 0. And these variable s1, s2 basic variable that we have to introduce in the objective function. So maximize z equal to 3x1 plus 4x2 plus 0s1 plus 0s2, and you bring everything to the left side. So z minus 3x1 minus 4x2 minus 0s1 minus 0s2 equal to 0. Now the standard form of LPP is, this is the objective equation and these are all the constraints. And represent the, you find the basic solution. So the basic solution is obtained by setting the decision variable, that is non-basic variable, to 0. The decision variables are x1 and x2. You fix the x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 0. In the constraint equation, if we substitute x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 0, s1 equal to 450, and here x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 0, s2 equal to 600, and in the z equation, x1, x2 equal to 0, z equal to 0. So this is what the starting solution, basic solution, which is shown in the table. Now, so the first row, the various variables, z, x1, x2, s1, s2, and the solution, and you have to calculate the intercept. And the z row, objective function, s1 row, s2 row. So from the standard form of LPP, we are representing in the form of a table. So z row, z equal to 1, minus 3, minus 4, 0, 0, 1, 0. S1, 0, 1, 1, S1 equal to 1, 0, 450. S2, 0, 2, 1, 0, 1, 600. Now, whether this solution is optimum, the answer is no, because we have an entering variable. So, the first step, you have to check, we have to find the entering variable. So, this is the maximization type of problem. The decision variable with the most negative coefficient will be the entering variable. So, the entering variable is most negative coefficient in decision variable in z row is x2. So, this is what the entering variable. Then, once you have the entering variable, you calculate the intercept. How do you calculate the intercept? So, the solution column divided by the entering column. So, 450 divided by 1, 450, 600 divided by 1, 600. Now, the intercept least value is the leaving variable. So, this is what the leaving variable in this problem. S1 is the leaving variable. So, pivot number 1, the intersection, the cell value intersection is 1. So, entering variable or entering column, leaving row or leaving variable, the intersection is 1, this cell, and this is called as pivot number or pivot element. Now, we have to go to the second iteration, calculation, and this is called as pivot number. Okay. Now, first, old pivot row, or how to calculate the new pivot row, new z row, new s1 row. Old pivot, new pivot row, that is equal to old pivot row divided by the pivot number. So, this is the old pivot row, that is 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 4, 50. So, 0, 1, 1, 0, 4, 50. Divide by the pivot number. Pivot number is 1. So, divide by pivot number, the same equation. That is what the new pivot row. New z row, that is current z row minus pivot column coefficient multiplied by new pivot row. So, old z row, 1, minus 3, minus 4, 0, 0, 0. That is 1, minus 3, minus 4, 0, 0, 0. Minus its pivot column coefficient. Minus of minus 4 into new pivot row. What is new pivot row? 0, 1, 1, 1, 4, 50. Hello. So, the minus of minus 4 into new pivot row, it gives 0, 4, 4, 4, 0, 180, 1800. Now, you add these two. So, 1, my, 1, 4, 0, 4, 0, 1800. Then new z row equal to old is new s2 row equal to old s2 row minus its pivot column coefficient into new pivot row. So look at the equation s2 row 0, 2, 1, 0, 1, 600. So 0, 2, 1, 0, 1, 600 minus of 1. So its pivot column coefficient is 1. The entering column coefficient is 1. So, minus of 1 into new pivot row. New pivot row is 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 4, 50. So, multiplying. So, 0, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, 0, minus 4, 50. Adding these two, 0, 1, 0, minus 1, 1, 150. The solution is given here in this table. So, the basic is z equation now, z equal to 1, x equal to 1, x1 equal to 1, x2 equal to 0, solution is 1800, x2 value 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 450, s2 value 0, 1, 0, minus 1, 1, 450, 1150. Now, you have to check for the next entering variable. The decision variable x1, x2, there is no negative value. So, this is maximization type of problem. The decision variable are x2 equal to 0, x1 equal to 1. There is no negative value and this solution is optimum. So, no more entering variable in the z row. No negative coefficient for maximization type of problem. So, the current solution is optimum. What is the solution now? x1 equal to 0. How x1 equal to 0? Initial solution x1 equal to 0, that is carried out. Okay, that is carried away. x2 equal to 450 and z maximum is 1800. This is the answer. x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 450 and z maximum equal to 1800. Now you take another problem. We take another example, problem number 4, using simplex method. Maximize z equal to 5x1 plus 10x2 plus 8x3, subject to the constraints 3x1 plus 5x2 plus 2x3 less than or equal to 60, 4x1 plus 4x2 plus 4x3 less than or equal to 72, 2x1 plus 4x2 plus 5x3 less than or equal to 100, and all the decision variables x1, x2, x3 are greater than or equal to 0. Now we have to convert the constraints. So in all the constraints, we have to add the slack variable. So 3x1 plus 5x2 plus 2x3 plus s1 equal to 60, 4x1 plus 4x2 plus 4x3 plus s2 equal to 72, 2x1 plus 4x2 plus 5x3 plus s3 equal to 100. So the standard form of the LPP. So you have to add s1, s2, s3 here, and the same values are to be included in the objective function. Z equal to 5x1 plus 10x2 plus 8x3, 0s1, 0s2, 0s3, and you bring everything to the left side. So z minus 5x1 minus 10x2 minus 10x3 minus 0s1 minus 0s2 minus 0s3 equal to 0. This is the standard form of the LPP, and you find the basic solution by fixing x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 0 and x3 equal to 0. So x1, x2, x3 equal to 0. So in the first constraint, substituting x1, x2, x3 equal to 0, s1 equal to 60. Here in the second constraint, s2 equal to 72 and the third constraint, s3 equal to 100. So in the z equation, if you substitute x1, x2, x3 equal to 0, z equal to 0. This is the starting solution. S1 equal to 60, s2 equal to 72 and s3 equal to 100, z equal to 0. And this starting solution is shown here in the table. Now, as per the procedure, the solution is not optimum. Look at the x1, x2, x3 value in the z equation, minus 5, minus 10, minus 8. So this is maximization type of problem. We have to first identify the entering variable, which is x2 here. So what is the condition is, among the three x values, the most negative coefficient is minus 10 and x2 is identified as the entering variable. And once you find the entering variable, then you have to calculate the intercept. So how to calculate the intercept? Solution column value divided by the entering column value. So 60 divided by 5, 72 divided by 4, 100 divided by 4. So 60 divided by 5 equal to 12, 72 divided by 4 equal to 18, 100 divided by 4 equal to 25. Among the three values, the least value is 12. So 12 corresponding variable is S1. S1 is the leaving variable. So X2 is the entering variable, S1 is the leaving variable, and the intersection 5 is the pivot number. Now, in the second iteration, iteration number 2, entering column is x2, leaving row is s1. So, you have to calculate the four rows, z row, s1, s1 equal to now s2, new, this is the pivot row now. So, new pivot row, z row, s2 row and s3 row. What is the formula? New pivot row equal to old pivot row divided by the pivot number. The entire equation is to be divided by the 5. That is what the new pivot row. And the new z row, the formula is old z row minus the entering column coefficient minus 10 into new pivot row, the new previous value. New s2 row equal to old s2 row minus the corresponding entering column coefficient is 4 into new pivot row. S3 row, new s3 row equal to old s3 row minus of 4, the entering column coefficient, into new pivot row. So using the equations, you calculate the new table and the new table is shown here. So everything is calculated, and now this is what the new table. And once again you check x1 equal to 1, x2 equal to 0, and x3 equal to minus 4. So x3 it takes minus 4 negative value. Again, this solution is also not optimal. So you have to once again take x3 as the entering variable. X3 as the entering variable. And once you got the entering variable, then you have to find out the intercept. So this is 24 divided by 2.4, 52 divided by 3.4. The least value is 10. So 24 divided by 2.4 equal to 10. And 52 divided by 3.4 equal to 15.3. And the least value is 10. And S2 is the leading loop. And the corresponding pivot number is 2.4. Now, the solution is not optimum because x3 has negative coefficient in the z row. And for the iteration 3, entering column is x3 and leaving row is s2. Now, the pivot row. New pivot row. So, the new pivot row equal to old pivot row. What is old pivot row? S2 row divided by 3. There is a mistake. Divided by 2.4. 2.4 is the pivot number. And the new z row, that is old z row, minus of minus entering column coefficient minus 4 into new pivot row. And the new x2 row, that is old x2 row, minus of the entering column coefficient 0.4 into new pivot row. The new s3 row, that is equal to old s3 row, minus of this 3.4 into new pivot row. So, you using this calculation, you have to calculate the new table. The new table is shown here. Now, look at the equation. X1 3.67, X2 equal to 0, X3 equal to 0, right? So, the Z row, X1, X2, X3 value, there is no negative value, and this present solution is optimal. So, what is your solution now? X2 equal to 8, X3 equal to 10, and Z equal to 160. So, the no more negative coefficient of decision variable in the Z row. So, the current solution is optimum. X2 equal to 8, X3 equal to 10, and X1 equal to 0, which is carried forward from the basic solution. So, there is no, actually, initially we assume X1 equal to 0, X2 equal to 0, X3 equal to 0. Now, it is improved. X1, there is no change. X1, there is no change. X2 is changed to 8, X3 is changed to 10. So, on the Z maximum, earlier basic solution it was 0, now it is improved, changed to 160. So, this is the solution for the problem. So, X1 equal to 0, X2 equal to 8, and X3 equal to 10, and Z maximum equal to 160. Now, you take the problem number 5, now we solve a minimization type of problem. So, using the simplest method, minimize z equal to x1 minus 3x1 minus 3x2 minus 2x3, subject to the constraint of 3x1 plus x2 plus 2x3 less than or equal to 7, minus 2x1 plus 4x2 less than or equal to 12, minus 4x1 plus 3x2 plus 4x3 less than or equal to 10, and the decision variable x1, x2, x3, they are greater than or equal to 0. So, in the constraint, in all the three constraints, you have to add the slack variable. So, 3x1 plus x2 plus 2x3. So, add slack variable in all the constraint and make the inequality constraint equal algebraic equations. So, here you have to add s1, here you have to add s2, and here you have to add s3 so that the constraint equation will become algebraic equations. So, now the standard form of the LPP. So, first constraint added S1, second constraint added S2, third constraint added S3, and these are all the values. And now X1, X2, X3, S1, S2, S3 are greater than or equal to 0. And these three variables are included in the Z equation. So, Z equation becomes Z equal to X1 minus 3X2 minus 2X3 plus 0s1 plus 0s2 plus 0s3. So you bring everything to the left side. There is a correction. Z minus x1 plus 3x2 plus 3 2x3 minus 0s1 minus 0s2 minus 0s3 equal to 0, subject to the constraint. So these are the three constraint equation, and you have to find the basic solution. So you find the basic solution fixing x1, x2, x3, the decision variable to 0. So fixing x1, x2, x3 equal to 0, and from the constraint equation, it becomes s1 becomes 7, s2 equal to 12, and s3 equal to 10. And z equal to 0. That is the starting solution or the basic feasible, basic solution for the problem. Now, the basic solution in the form of a table. So you take the, draw the table, write all the details here in this equation. Now you check the z row. Z row, x1, x2, x3, coefficient minus 1, 3 and 2. For minimization type of problem, the decision variable with the maximum coefficient is the entering variable. So here 3 is maximum among the three values. So this is what the entering variable, x2 is the entering variable, and this is the entering column. So once you got the entering column, then you have to calculate the intercept. Intercept, you should not take this s1 row because we have a negative denominator. So the denominator should be positive. Suppose if you have some negative denominator, you drop this. You should not consider this row for the leading. So 12 divided by 4, 3. 10 divided by 3, 3.3. So the least value. So minimum value, the intercept minimum value is what the leading row. And this is S2 is the leading. So X2 is the entering column. And S2 is the leading row. And the corresponding pivot number is 4. So this is what the entering variable for a minimization problem. The decision variable with the most positive coefficient x2. Leaving variable, find the intercept, that is solution column divided by the entering column. Delete the negative denominator. The basic variable with the least intercept is s2. That is what the leaving variable, and the pivot number equal to 4. Now we go for the second iteration, the calculation. The same formula what we used in the previous problem, we have to repeat. New pivot row x2 is equal to current pivot row divided by the pivot number, and z new z row equal to old z row minus of the entering column coefficient 3 into new pivot row, and new s1 row equal to old s1 row minus of minus 1 into new pivot row, and new s3 row equal to old s3 row minus of 3 into new pivot row, and the results are given here. So this is what the result for this second iteration. Now once again check the value x1, x2, x3. Now x1 equal to, in the z row, x1 is 0.5, x2 equal to 0, and x3 equal to 2. So this is the highest value. So now the entering variable is x3, and the corresponding, actually the intercept you calculate, 10 divided by 2, 5, and 1 divided by 8 equal to 0.125. The least intercept is 0.125, and S3 is the leaving row. So the solution is not optimum. X1, X3 in the Z row have positive coefficients. So go to the third iteration. Entering variable is X3, leaving variable is S3, and the pivot number is 8. Now once again, procedure. New pivot row X3, new pivot row X3 equal to old pivot row S3 divided by the pivot number, which is 8. New Z row equal to old Z row minus of 2 into new pivot row, and new S1 row equal to old S1 row minus of 2 into new pivot row, and the new X2 row equal to old X2 row into 0 into new pivot row. So results are given here in the table. So once again, X1, X2, X3, X2 is 0, X3 equal to 0, now X1 equal to 1.12. Now here x1 is the entering variable, and these two rows, they have the negative denominator. The only option is s1. S1 is leaving. So the pivot number is 3.12. So entering variable is x1, leaving variable is s1, and the pivot number is 3.12. Now, once I calculate the equation, where is fourth iteration, new pivot row is x1, current pivot row is s1, divided by the pivot number 3.12, new z row equal to old z row minus half 1.12 into new pivot row, and new x2 row equal to old x2 row minus half minus 0.5 into new pivot row, and new x3 row equal to old x3 row minus half minus 0.31 into new pivot row. So what you do when you listen to the lecture, you just take the formula and calculate, verify the answer, or you just read the formula, take the answer, and I give the assignment problem, you try to solve using the procedure. And even if you have any more doubt, right, you better you purchase some book on the operation research, or take the book from the library, have some textbook on the operation research, and you compare, follow the procedure. And the result is optimum now, because x1, x3, in the z row, everything is 0. So results are x1 equal to 3.12, x2 equal to 4.56, x3 equal to 1.10, and the z minimum value is minus of 12.76. So this is the answer for the minimization type of problem. So finally, I have a quote. We see the world not as it is, but as we are. So how we see the world, it depends on our knowledge and experience. So when we are positive, everything appears positive. When we are negative, everything appears as negative. So thank you. We'll meet again.